Until today, the promise that the Creator gave to Abraham and to Isaac and to Jacob and to the holy tribes is always and was and will always be for the general public of Israel, for the whole 12 tribes of Israel. For an example, think about it, that Moses, that he was the redeemer of our nation, of our people. He took out 12 tribes out of Egypt and led them into the toward the Holy Land of Israel for 40 years in the desert. But when he passed away, so his own children, the children of Moses, went back to the camp of Jethro that was out of the Holy Land, and they stayed there. They stayed out. Now, Moses never entered the Holy Land. He never saw and visited the temple in the Holy Land. He was never in the holy city of Jerusalem. And his children also never inherited the Holy Land. And they stayed outside. And they lost their connection to the nation of Israel. And they lost their connection to the tribe of Judah, the Jewish people of today. And where are they? Can we even for 1 second think about that as a normal thing for us to forget about Moses' children? But where are they? Who are they? Today you cannot put your finger on them and say, hey, I know you, you're the child of Moses. You're like, you're one of his seed, you're one of his great-grandchildren. You don't know. Why you don't know? Because they have been mixed between the nations. And they are one of the lost tribes of Israel. They're one of the lost souls that we, as Jewish or as people that believe in the truth of the Torah and the oral Torah that have been given to the Israeli nation, we have that obligation from above, and we must commit ourselves to it, to bring them back to our nation, to hold them in their arms and to pull them from their darkness and to redeem them and to help them, to call them back. It's our obligation. The world does not exist. Because Olam Milshon Ne'elem, the world is just blocking the light of truth. The world calls Alma